The rain turned to snow and the crowd drifted away, left to deal with their sorrow.
We come to you with broken hearts.
Broken hearts that will never fully heal. Pain that is now unbearable.
Life's short. You know, tomorrow's never promised.
Vicente Juarez's family grieved with hundreds of others who came to show their support to the friends and families of the men who were killed.
It's amazing, you know, how fast things can happen. I'll remember him forever.
Vicente Juarez was one of five men shot to death on Friday. Crosses were put up in memory of Vicente, who was a grandfather of eight.
He was a great person, a loving father, a great uncle. It's a shame. It's a really big shame.
And Trevor Wayner, an intern on his first day. Josh Pinkard, who texted his wife that he loved her before he died. Clayton Parks, a loving father and devoted husband. And Russell Bayer, who had vouched for the gunman and helped him get his job back 2 months before he killed him.
Sometimes we think we take things for granted and, you know, anything can happen at any moment. You could leave your house not knowing if you're ever going to come back.
When the prayer vigil was over, a group walked 4 miles to the Aurora Police Department to put up crosses for the officers injured when they ran into a spray of bullets, no doubt saving the lives of many others.
The scars and wounds they bear may not be seen on the surface, but linger deep in their souls. Heal all who bear wounds from this tragic event.
The Juarez family may have come together in pain and tragedy, but they are now leaning on each other for comfort.
Definitely bringing the family even closer than we were already.
And Vicente Juarez's niece told me earlier today, it just really hurts and it's not fair. I'm live in Aurora, Marcella Raymond, WGN News.